Inspired by LOL Surprise, OMG Neonlicious, we are going to make a plastic overall dress using a binder pouch that we bought at Target for $2.99. I absolutely love using back-to-school items for the dollhouse. Let's start by making a simple skirt. Cut the pouch around the edges to separate the two sides. Take a doll skirt, open it up, trace around it on a piece of paper to make a pattern. Cut it out, wrap it around your doll, and make adjustments where needed. I want my skirt to just flare out a little bit more, so I'm redrawing it and making a few alterations. Okay, I like that shape. Once you have your pattern, place it onto the clear plastic. I run my fingernail around the edge to make an indention. Remove the pattern, carefully cut on the line to get the shape of our skirt. Cut Velcro, pull the two pieces apart. Take one piece, place it on the end, on the top. I can sew it on by hand using a needle and thread. However, because the materials are a little tough, this will take a lot of time, and I have to really be careful because they like to move while sewing. Another option is to place the skirt on tissue paper, trace around it, cut out two, place the plastic on top, then the Velcro, then use a sewing machine to sew on the Velcro, making sure the tissue paper is on the bottom. Without the tissue paper, the plastic kept sticking to my machine, making it impossible to sew. Well, for me anyway, the tissue paper helps to just make it glide right across. Take the other side of the Velcro and place it underneath on the other end of the skirt. Place the other piece of tissue paper under the plastic and sew it on just like before. Now we have the Velcro sewn on both ends, and the plastic is between two pieces of tissue paper. For a little extra detail, I'm going to sew a line around the top edge, sewing right through both layers of tissue paper. Carefully pull away the tissue paper. It does take a minute to remove all of those small pieces of tissue paper, but it's totally worth it because when you're done, you have a plastic skirt. I'm gonna pair it with some metallic leggings from Barbie and the Rockers for a look that is out of this world. Now let's take it up a notch and try the overalls. This time I'm using a pink planner. It has a pink plastic cover that is neon, so the edges almost seem like they're glowing. We can carefully remove the cover and still use the planner. Take the skirt pattern, take more paper, and cut out a small rectangle for the bib. We will also need a pocket and two straps. For the straps, I'm going to keep them together while sewing on the details, then cut them to separate them afterwards. So here are all of my pieces for the overall dress. Place the pattern onto the plastic. Rather than using my nail, this time I'm using the end of a crochet needle to trace around it. Cut it out. Here are all of our pieces. First thing I'm going to do is sew a line across the top of the pocket. Take tissue paper, place the plastic in the center, place another piece of tissue paper on top, lining the edge up with the plastic. Sew a line straight across, remove the paper, tie the string into knots on the ends, trim off the excess, place the pocket in the middle of the larger rectangle, use tissue paper to cover the back and the small pocket, sew along the side, bottom, and up the other side. Remove the paper. Yay! Now the pocket is attached, and we can actually put stuff in it. Take the long rectangle that we're using for the straps, cover it with tissue paper, use a ruler to draw two thin rectangles. Sew on the line drawn, remove the tissue paper, cut it in half, trimming off the excess where needed to make the straps. Place them in the top corners of the bib. Using a needle and thread, carefully stitch it into place. Now we're going to use a sewing machine to reinforce the stitch. Cover the front and back of the bib with tissue paper. sew a straight line going up the side, across the top, and down the other side. Remove the paper. Find the center point of the skirt by folding it in half and cut a small notch. Place the bib behind the skirt at the center point. Bend the skirt to line it up with the bottom edge. I put tissue paper on the back of the skirt because I need to be able to see the bib to position it when attaching it. It wasn't too bad. I just finished sewing it and I had to go really slow and bend it slightly as I went. Add Velcro, just as before. Place it on your doll to know where you would like to put the straps. Sew them in place and trim off the excess to make a plastic overall dress. That looks great with a tank top and biker shorts. I got the tank top from the Fresh Dolls, and we made the biker shorts by modifying a Fresh Doll dress. If you would like to see a video for that, let us know in the comments down below. Now let's make a clear bag, inspired by transparent designer bags. I'm using a clear binder pouch from Target, cut to remove the sides, separating the two pieces. This might be kind of hard to see with the clear, so let's use yellow for a demonstration. First, let's make a pattern using a piece of paper. Draw a long rectangle, cut it out, fold it in half, then trim it for the width of the purse. Fold over the sides, trace along the bottom edge, then draw twice the length of the sides to make a triangle. Cut it out. To make a pattern, place it onto the plastic, cut two large rectangles and one small one. Use the strap pattern from our overalls to cut another longer rectangle. Using tissue paper, make the straps first. I find that using a pin to go under the paper to remove it makes it go a lot easier. After cutting to separate the two straps, sew one onto the large rectangle, repeat to make two, stack them so the good side is facing out, sew down the sides. On second thought, I was going to give the bottom of my bag a rectangular shape, but that might be kind of complicated given the type of material. So we're just gonna sew along the side, across the bottom, and up the other side. So I cut a large piece of tissue paper and then sew using my sewing machine. After removing the paper, turn the bag inside out, pinch the bottom corners to make a triangle, sew a straight line going across the top of the triangle, not forgetting to use tissue paper. Repeat on the other side, flip it right side out to make a clear tote bag. To give it that designer look, take a paint pen that can write on plastic, write a few words. I put a piece of foam board inside the bag to give me a surface to write on. Then I wrote my Froggy stuff, switching up some of the letters to make it a little more interesting. Then I wrote a few more things to fill in the space. Allow it to dry to make the dolls a designer-inspired bag. Little Froggy here, now let's resize it for real life. I'm gonna use that designer technique and customize a pencil case for back to school. $2.99 at Target. And I'm using a medium Sharpie paint pen. First, I need to design my font using a marker and a piece of paper. I'm making one inspired by the Hermes Kelly bag. After writing the alphabet, I practice writing what's going to be on the bag. Now take the pencil case, I take washi tape and make guidelines on the bag. This helps a lot with keeping the letters evenly spaced and in line. Now take the paint marker and begin drawing your design on the bag. After finishing the design and allowing it to dry, remove the tape, add some finishing touches, and you have your very own designer back to school pencil case. And there are so many things that you can customize, like a clear phone case from Five Below, a clear tote from Target, and an umbrella. Well, my work here is done. Peace out. We hope you get creative and have fun with this craft. Thank you for joining us while we made clear fashion for our dolls using back-to-school items and gave them that designer touch. Like, comment, share, and subscribe. Don't forget to ring the bell and follow us on Instagram at MyFroggyStuff and the Frog Vlog.
And you're done.
Happy crafting!
We want to give a shout out to Maya S. What's up? Ooh, let me say, I love your look! Thank you! I love yours too! Aw, you're so sweet! Thank you! I just gotta know, where did you buy that bag? I didn't buy it. I made it! No way! Yes way! Come on, I'll show you how.